at your best, at my best. Everything I do is for my highest good. I know that I'm a queen. I'm destined for the promised land. I guess they say I love way too hard, or they call me crazy. I am a trending topic daily. Yes. Y'all be laughing, but you know, it's laugh now, cry later. And them shots you send, I send them right back. I'm gonna remind y'all about everything y'all do. You know, there is no peace or no sleep for the wicked, none. So while you're up, you're gonna be thinking about me constantly. So do something more productive with your time. I am a legend in the hood, or a god in the hood, or a god that they look up to. So I could be their god, who knows? So we work in here, so work, my friend working, and I'm working. And guess what? I really ain't working. I'm just like telling y'all this real shit that I know. So right here, it says Psalms 5, chapter 5, verse 12. It says, bless the righteous, O Lord. You cover him with favor as a shield. So you must be righteous and God got you. Like, ain't no in between once again. Do you know someone can steal your blessings being reckless? So protect your soul at all times. Yes, it does sound strange, but the enemy does come to kill, steal, and destroy. So that describes the devil. Yes, they can steal your blessings, delay you, but they can never change your destiny. Like someone above you, like your parents can, but what's destined for you, nobody can take. They steal it by using black magic, which is forbidden. That's sick. It's so sickening. And that's what demons do. I mean, they're envious. Like, if I ever wake up hating on anybody, don't let me wake up. It happens more than a person can imagine or realize. Blessings are special favor, mercy. So the blessings that God has are joy, gladness, loving, for you to be couples, glad song, pleasure, delight, love, peace, companionship, which I know is a lot of more blessings. Like, I mean, I'm got blessings on blessings on blessings. But also, vision takes a person to destination. Vision creates room for next levels. Some cases are extreme spiritual warfare, which I endure. Like, I'm talking about nobody can walk in my shoes. I don't even know how I endure this shit. Like, I don't even know how I make it. Like, I know, like, y'all can hear it in my voice. Like, I can't even breathe. I can't breathe. But I don't know why I'm the one that can't breathe if I keep my foot on their neck. And it's accidental. Like, I don't want to pressure anybody. I mind my business, stay in my own lane. But for some reason, they're pressed. So, oppression, that shit's at an all-time high, and only God can take that hate away. I mean, it's like malicious, like just evil. Like, I never saw anything like what I've been through these last 3 years. Like, I never knew this existed, honestly. Like, basically, all witches hate me. Guess what? Because I'm a god, but I'm here to make them submit to God. So I'm going to keep applying as much pressure as I have to. And they're going to repent. And even though they sold out, they're still going to honor a God like me forever and ever and ever and ever. Because, yes, they're going to remember me. They can never lose these memories, period. Because I'm here for this new world order. It's mine. And my blessings are bigger than the human eye can imagine. I implant a seed of destiny, and the promise is within me, just like it's within you. So use your full potential, unlock your entire future by keeping faith and pray without ceasing. So that's all I do is pray it up till my day's up. So God will isolate you in order to prepare you for the transformation. So when you're alone, just humble yourself and just breathe in and out and meditate and whatever it takes to get through it, because it will be worth it if you just trust and believe in the Creator. And I decree and declare that any demonic beings have no access to me. God ain't gonna let it happen. Like, people can't even step to me that are not aligned or halfway aligned with me. Like, I'm ascended for real. I'm with the ones they look up to. I'm on the front line every day, stepping into my identity. Like, it's not hard for y'all to step into your identity. Like, if y'all stop worried about the next person, then worry about yourself, then that would be great. Because then you could manifest your power, manifest your life, elevate yourself. So, God's power, or the power within, is meant to position you, and it's definitely going to position me to meet everything I need to meet in order to make myself and God proud and everybody else. I'm not here to get the world's judgment, but I'm doing this relentlessly, easily. And I am going to be comfortable through the good and the bad. I need no one to validate me. Know this. I have my own tribe from the heavens. You know, it's 12 tribes, right? Well, like, one of them's for Elizabeth. I don't know. I guess it's the descendants of David. I don't know. Gotta be, because my daddy's David and I'm a descendant. So, God gang or don't bang. And I hear they looking for me, but I can't tell because I'm not hiding. Like I told you, I'm on the front line daily. I'm grateful. I trust the universe. Everything works out perfectly for me, Elizabeth Browner. I'm worthy of receiving. My business gets better every day. I am favored with abundance, and I am pursuing my happiness and my children's happiness, like my family is everything. God is love. God is me. God is she. I don't chase money. Money chases me. I am a money magnet. Money flows to me easily. I love myself and who I am. I lay my gifts and talents before you. And I'm going to keep doing it because it just is what it is. The best is yet to come. Nobody can stop me. I'm all the way up. And God will show up and show out every day and all day for me. There's only glory in the unseen. I am Elizabeth Browner, and I am a master builder. In the beginning of the Bible, I don't know if y'all know, it's when Moses got to the promised land. He will tell you the way of life. Things get tough when you get close to the promised land. The enemy be striking at all time high. You might not have no money. You might just be going through it. That's me. But I don't worry. I seek God. They stalk me, but guess what? They can't stop me. I'm so close. People in life will practice a necessary evil to try to stop you, but they're only delaying me a little because I'm going to come back like so much. They accelerate me. When they delay me, they accelerate me and they delay themselves. I don't got time for phony people anymore. I stand alone. I stay by myself. I don't like niggas. I don't like bitches. I don't like nobody. Excuse my language, but big facts. God has something with my name on it, and he has something with your name on it. If you didn't sell out already, know this. You have to go through the good. First, you're at good. Then you have to go through the grief to get to the great. God is the greatness. Know that. So, with God by me, I know that I can shake down nations, and I will fill them with glory. God is my silver, my gold, and my glory. Know that greater is virtue, not a vice. Know that God works miracles through me, and he can it through you too if you're his child. God is love. Whew, I can't breathe a lot of times. Don't be obsessed with anything. Just continue to strive and do not have over ambition, because that is a deadly sin. So, great is the Lord. Praise is the reflection of revelation. That is just something that I quote. Great, good, and medium. Big, great is big God. Big God. Good is small, and medium is a good God. So I'm trying to get to that greater. Nations are us. God will make your name great. Yes, because if he lives through you, then you are destined for greatness. So don't settle with an average anointing. Don't be blind. Open your eyes and keep them up. Nothing average will ever be Elizabeth Browner. Never be a basic. I will never be basic. I am real rare. Culture, not kingdom. Understand? Can't be humble and great. Greatness exposes arrogance, and it triggers what's within. Evelation should not trigger your greatness. Understand your assignment better when you leave than before you came. So be better from... like, the results seem to be better than when you came. So, I'm irreplaceable, unforgettable. You know my name, Elizabeth Browner. God is she. God is the only one that can make it change. Like, God is the only one that can stop me. Like, and basically that's me. So... I have the decision, the power is within me to meet my goals just like you. So, no distractions, no delays, no oppositions can distract me. Ooh, the art of ignoring you demons. Ha, nah, for real. Neighbors can assassinate my character, but it can't distract me, bother me, they slander me, they cannot stop me from building, but they can help me lose focus, but that's what the devil wants, to distract you from praying and thinking about God and pursuing God and just trusting God. Don't let it shake you. Be strong. Greater is he that is in the world. Yes. Understand? Yes. Understand. Temptations in life are not different from other experiences. Like, I made it through all my trials and my tribulations thus far, and I'm going to continue. God is faithful. Don't let temptation tempt you. He will make sure you override and conquer all of your enemies. All my enemies must die. Everything that they plan for me is what they plan for themselves. Little do they know. But I gotta go, y'all. So just follow me, Spiritually Street Journey. I am on, and I pave the way for mine and others. I just want y'all to wake up. I am unmasking witchcraft. Definitely. I definitely am. And I'm going to keep speaking it until I'm heard, period. This is for the stuff.